Hello guys, this is my first time making a video in English. For those of you that are watching me for the first time, let me introduce myself a little. I have 8 years experience in Forex trading, and I am the leader and the founder of the biggest community in my country here. I can proudly say that 90% of Albanians have gone through my lessons, my teachings, through my videos that I have posted here in this channel. So my main teachings is to never be dependent on someone else. This is my core principle in all of my teachings. And you know what my wife is being accused of? She's being accused of that I am trading on her behalf, which is not true at all. So check this out. I made a tweet before. As you can see, as I said, it's time to speak up. I have been silent for this for more than 1 month because I thought that they are going to solve this in private way. But my wife have been accused of violation of terms and conditions, husband trading or in behalf of wife. Have you ever seen this kind of accusation before? You let me know in comments or something. This is very strange. And this is very funny. I mean, it's funny, strange, it's stupid. I don't know what this is. Because this is not true at all. The facts are that we don't even live together. She lives in a different city. We are engaged. We are not married yet. And they made an accusation like, hey, your husband is trading on your behalf. Without zero proofs. She have sent more than 20 emails, which I'm going to show you right now, each and one of them, asking for proofs. They provide zero in private way, zero, zero, zero. So all this video, this tweet is to bring public attention to this one, so you can be aware of this. And once I made this case public, you know what happened? Matt Lee have just blocked me. Because of the first time, only this page have blocked me. So they have blocked me before making this public. But once I made it public, Matt Lee, of course, he blocked me because I have tagged him here. The post is going very viral right now. Many people are tagging him and stuff like that, as you can see. And they are not answering at all. Of course, they just want to avoid this and stuff like that. But this video is to explain what have happened in details. And I'm going to show you right now all of my side story of my emails, and you can be the judge. So here is the case, and watch this video up to the end to see the full story. So here's the dashboard of my wife. She had a $3,000 account, and all of my teaching to all of my students, even my wife, even my friends or other family members, I always tell to everyone, make 2 to 4%, ask for withdrawal. Never go above 4% or 3% because prop firms makes cause you troubles. They go to you, they try to say IP match and stuff like that. You know, stupid reasons. But you can't ever find stupid than this one. Sorry for my bad English, it's my first time making video. So she made around 2%, as you can see, and she made some profits here, and the withdrawal date, it was at 11 January. She has been a consistent trader throughout with 6 payouts or 7, and once they saw that she is always making profits, they decided to ban her with stupid reason, as you can see. They even sent a payout reminder. Hey, you have a payout reminder in a few days. Right at this moment, 1 day later, they send this one, breach detection. Isn't this a funny coincidence or other? I don't know what I can say this. You can judge again. So what happened after these emails? She received this email, then she replied. These are the screenshots. I'm going to show you the facts, the proofs. She's not very good in English, so she uses Google Translate. And she, of course, said, this might be a misunderstanding, an error from your side. Nobody's trading on my behalf. I have experience in 2 years. First of all, I'm not married. I can send you the certificate of family if you want to prove that to you. Can I know what proofs are you saying to this? It seems you are just trying to find excuses to deny me payouts that will come soon. In few days. They replied like this. Thanks for reaching out. Upon your reviewing activity, it becomes apparent, regardless of who is trading. As you can see, we have decided department to monitor across the platform, blah, 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 stuff like that. As a result, we have breached your accounts. You know, no, zero proofs. You see any proof here? No proof. Okay, let's go to the next. So then she said, hello again. This is not okay at all. I have the right to know the proofs why you're breaching my account, otherwise this looks like a fraud. You are just stealing away my account and banning me without reason at all. This seems to look like a total scam. Show me the proofs. You can't just say someone is trading without any proofs and just remove. Of course not. It's not morally correct. But still, let's go see another replies. I will need to forward this issue to the department. Okay. Fine, we wait, it's still in progress. Yes, go ahead, please, because I'm sure this has to be a mistake. I am 100% blah, blah, blah. That's what she said. So please check it up and hope it will be fixed soon. Okay, we wait. Hello, this is Yes for MyFundedFX. Upon further review, their account and Qt management has decided to keep your account suspended. Please note that account management... Nothing, still no proofs, zero. Ask it three times. In progress. Hello again. I don't see any proof. This is so unfair, of course. You are just saying somebody have managed my account with blah, 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 blah. Show me the proofs. Bigger caps, lock letters. You can see. You can judge it. You can see. This is just because I'm profitable and you want me out. Okay. Show me the proofs. Poof, ticket is just resolved. It's just closed. Total ignore, you can see it in this case. So this was the first time. Then what happens? Then she tried to contact them again. Like, here is my all the trying again. Sending message. Hello again, new ticket. As you can see, zero response. Kakaroto from the Goku, I don't know who the fuck is he. Same copy-paste email. The decision is final. Zero proofs again. Okay, 11 January. As you can see, he simply just closed this. And this is what my wife have replied. I want to show me the proofs for what you are saying. This is not true at all. I have been trader for almost 2 years. I know the rules of your company are very well. I never violated them. I have made several withdrawals and not had any problems. I don't understand, and we don't understand, right? Nobody understands why they are making this problem. You are a serious company, at least that's how I considered you, blah, blah, blah. If you are sure about why you're accusing me of, then show me the facts. It's been the 8th time or 10th time, I don't know how many times she's been asking. You definitely show the facts. Zero, still again zero. And the case is resolved. It's resolved by just closing the ticket. You see, this is how they discuss in private way. That's why I'm making this video, making exposing them. Because they can do this to anyone. And resolved. Stop ignoring me. Show me the proofs. In this way, you can clarify this problem. As you can see, found suspicious. I don't know. You can see, you can judge it by yourself. Tell me if this is fair enough. This is... So the first message was ignored, and then another message still was ignored, as you can see. So we can go to the next one. As you can see, 4 days later, another email, but still ignored, nothing. So the Gio, stop ignoring me, is the second time you've done the same thing. Here's a, as I mentioned, designer staff member who handles this matter. In your last email with him, same, still copy paste, ignore, and it's done. So this was a few days ago. The end, right, the conversation. Yes. Then, all I want from you, she said, show me the proofs. I want an interview. Otherwise, what you are doing right now is a fraud. This won't end well if you keep continuing. Can you give me an answer? I am waiting for a response. Still. Ignore completely. Let's continue. Same. So, she tried to another guy. Yes. She tried to Gio. Yes. Kakaroto. Goku. I don't know what the fuck are those names. And Panthera. I don't know. Same emails. Every single one from their support is ignoring her. Like treating like trash. Nobody. As you can see. Panthera support, yes, the same email, Kakaroto, same email, Gio, what the fuck, every one of them. And this is the today's email. This email have been sent 12 hours ago and still no reply. Still no reply. As you can see, you can judge it by yourself right now. And also, one more extra thing. I already have an account with them. I have a face to account with them. As you can see it here, I have a phase 2 account where my target is to reach 5%, and they never notified me anything about what was going on with my wife. Do you know why? Because they are waiting for me to fail the phase 2 and so I don't get a refund. But if I pass it, they will give me a refund. You know, this is the shady part that they are doing. I even asked them and told them, hey, why don't can you ask config manager, because this is thing, I'm a phase 2. They told me that, yeah, you can go. The ambitious man. I was expecting Kakaroto, but it's ambitious man right now. So, did you have a chance to discuss with them? Yes, you already traded the account. Yes, you are able to trade it. They are just saying me, yes, you are able to trade it, the second phase. They never notified me that I'm trading her account or whatsoever. So, how can I trust them? Will you trust them in this case? Let me know what you think. So, forget all of this. To be honest, I'm not even surprised a little. But the reason husband trading on your behalf, that was the epic one. Because always the pro firms catch you with, you know, IP stuff. They come up with different reasons, like just trying to deny or ban you. We are used to that, but this one was way different. I think it won the the deny payout award. Maybe they should do the pro team reviews deny awards in this case. So I'm not surprised at all, because they don't have regulations. Any pro firm that exists don't have regulations, and as long as they don't have regulations, we are all fucked up. Because they are acting as gods, they are acting as regulators, they are acting as nobody can stop them, you know? And we have to know, as the traders, the most important thing that they care about is their reputations and their sales to stupid and idiot, ignorant peoples. Because they don't want to see, they don't want to believe, they don't want to see the reality of how the prop firm works. And they are their assets. So don't be an asset for them. Be a liability. Become profitable so you will have some kind of problems like this. So having this kind of problems is the new flex in this industry, as you can see. So I'm already finishing up this video. So if this video have opened your eyes just a little bit, share it with your friends, share it everywhere. Try to spread awareness of this situations, and I think we have won the denial payout award. Okay, goodbye. Thank you very much.